I couldn't even tell you what the show is.
So we're okay for tonight, and we'll scratch Friday.
Yeah, come on down tonight, but try and don't shoot the whole thing.
Oh my God, he's taking a picture.
Yes.
Kids, how are you?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Come on, let's go in my room. Hi, Abe. Hi, kids.
Hi.
Why is it locked? Go in here. Come on.
Tell me what the film's about for you.
Well, the film is about, you don't know what it's about. That's what it's about. The film, you have no clue what this is about. So I'm going to just start with you, and if somebody wants to join us, an interview with Amanda or Pearl or Todd or any of these people have absolutely no bearing on this.
So it was obviously going to be a long couple of weeks for me and my film crew. Already, Meatloaf canceled interviews I'd set up with a few of his friends and family members.
And what this is Seize the Night Tour 2007. Not about 1994, not about 1987, not about any of that. It's not about that. It's about here and now. It's about right this minute.
Well, what are we doing? Everybody needs to get up and check like we're going to do it. I've got so much to do, and we had so little time.
We're in rehearsal before an 18-month world tour where we're playing arenas like Madison Square Garden, Wembley Arena.
What are we doing up there, John?
And we're getting ready to launch a Canadian tour where the eighth show is going to be a DVD shoot.
Hey, Joe, talk to me.
So it's an amazing amount of pressure. Not many artists on an eighth show are going to be comfortable shooting a DVD of a world tour.
So the storm is standing. Laugh and laugh today.
If I don't get some shelter, I'm gonna fade away. Oh.
I'm a nervous wreck coming in here today. I'm freaking out. I couldn't sleep last night. I'm changing the show this morning as I'm going.
Give me that line next time. Okay, now do that with chords. Can you do that? Can you do that sort of with chords without doing
that?
Let's try it again. Let's try that. I'm just going.
He throws quick things at the band. Like the Gimme Shelter thing, that's sort of a last-minute thing.
There's only so much you can do with it.
Right.
Probably the most repetitious song in the history of rock and roll.
Well, then how come it's so famous and people love it so much?
With Gimme Shelter, nothing is ever a surprise with Meatloaf. You have to expect the unexpected always.
Total improv continuously. I work off the seat of my pants. I work off the top of my head, but I don't think.
Play that line, Paul. Play me.
Yeah, C, C, G, A flat.
Yeah. Who has suggestions?
Instead of going to the last verse, you can just do the great murder, it's just a shadow way. I'm going to end it with the chorus anyway.
And then do the first chorus up and then break it down.
Yeah.
Good suggestion. I just thought of that right before you said it.
Stake is my reputation, and my reputation is always at stake no matter when I step on stage to do the best show you possibly can do. And if I can't do that, then I'm not going. You're finding out who I am right now. You know, I'm an A personality who's made a lot of mistakes. I've been an asshole in my life, you know, and I'm trying to improve. There you go. Now, what else you want to know?
And then you took the words right out of my mouth. Oh, it must have been while you were kissing me.
Meatloaf was born Marvin Lee Adday in September 1947.
My understanding of the name Meatloaf is his dad called him Meat, and his high school coach called him The Loaf.
He had a very tormented childhood because he wasn't only big, he was very big and very fat. And neighbors would say things like, "You're too fat to play with my children."
I believe growing up, Meatloaf must have always had some kind of self-doubt. And he looks at the cup half empty. But he knows that if he works harder and he puts his talent out there, that the cup will be full.
Much a democracy in the band, but there has to be kind of some kind of captain of the team, so I guess that would best describe my position as, like, I'm the Derek Jeter of Meatloaf's world.
In here, that's the key change.
You would think that, all we have to do is play what's on the record, but that's not the case. It's like, once you get into a live environment, the rules change, you know, and what works on a record doesn't always work live.
Meat and I have been together going on 6 years. I did go out for the first few years from start to end, but for me it got pretty old, pretty fast. Things changed, we moved, we got dogs, I found myself wanting to be at home a lot more. Even though I'm not on tour and I'm physically not present, we do spend a lot of time either iChatting, being on the telephone with each other. He will ask me for my suggestions at times. I will make a suggestion if I feel that, you know, it will help. But I leave that, because he's so strong at the creative process, that I leave that to him.
Not a fan of miniskirts, because we're on an elevated stage.
I think I had something to do with that. The DVD in Australia, check it out.
Okay, we've got the first act. We're going to go, it's black, white, it's dressier.
Okay.
Less hooker, more Studio 54. No, that's bad. More sports banquet.
Well, this is what we were wondering. Would you be opposed to us, pretty much from Took the Words on, instead of wearing the stuff we've been wearing that's much more hard, what if we looked a little bit more classy, like dresses or pantsuits for that whole first act?
Perfectly fine with me.
That's okay if we're dressier.
What happens in the first 45 seconds?
Curtain opens.
Yep.
Everybody's standing there. They're frozen.
Okay.
That starts.
With no music.
Nothing.
Yeah, and?
Play it.
There's no music.
Exactly.
The Meatloaf that I know is a very, very concerned artist. And that concern sometimes overwhelms him, because most artists just don't have that kind of concern. They hire the stylist, they hire the lighting person, they hire the sound man, they hire the engineer. Meat's involved in every aspect of his art, and not many artists are.
And this one's actually great. I think I...
Yeah?
Yeah.
Let's get a red one.
Yeah? Okay.
Yeah. Let's get that beginning down, and then we can go home.
One, two, three, four.
You play with them, but you play around with them. In other words, play with them, but fill the hole where they're... Fill the stop.
How do you feel? End of day one rehearsal.
I have no idea. It's the end of day one.
Well, you said you're an in-the-moment guy, so right now, in the moment, right this second.
I feel nothing. I feel it's the end of day one. I'm wondering what's for lunch tomorrow.
I'm here to pet the dog. Watch.
Greetings, oh great one.
There you go. Oh. This is a very lovely house of Eric Vitro.
I met him about a year ago when he was making Bad Outta Hell 3, and I started coming into the studio to work with him on the album. Perfect. And I've worked with him ever since, yeah, and it's been great.
That was a miracle warm-up.
Oh, that was good, wasn't it? Yeah, why did he come to me after all these years? I think that everyone's voice changes as the years go on, as they get older, as they try different music. Now roll your shoulders all the way around to loosen them up. Drop your arms on the high note. I warm up his voice before concerts. I get him in a good, healthy place vocally, in a good, healthy place mentally to perform. You know, Meatloaf is always striving to do better. He's always striving to get better, to sing better. So I think for him, he just wanted some new techniques to use and to bring his voice to another level. He doesn't follow, like, good, sensible things I tell him, like, you know, get enough sleep or get enough rest. Don't overuse your voice tonight. No, that all goes out the window.
You can do it, but you have to sign that you did it.
Can't, you know, because he, okay, he's got a little bit of the bad boy. You know, he's a little wild at times.
Oh, my God.
I think he looks very good with this mustache.
He actually looks very handsome.
Yeah.
Poor Bryan Cranston.
I initialed.
Good.
There you go.
Things that you'll do.
In the air, there's thunder in the sky, and a killer's on the bloodshot streets. Oh, and down the tunnel where the deadly horizon, or swell saw a young boy down in the gutter, he stuck up the bowl in the heat.
No one wanted to play the Bat Out of Hell record, so it was really Meatloaf doing what Meatloaf does. His ability to move the record company, the radio station, or move the audience in the club to the point that after a year, stations started to play songs.
I'm gonna hit the highway like a battering ram on a silver black Phantom bike.
He sold out stadiums.
And he worked the country and then the world. He created something that was just a phenomenon.
The album was selling 500,000 copies a week. It sold more copies than Sgt. Pepper. It was, you know, one of the biggest rock albums of all time. He was a huge star.
Paradise by the Dashboard Light is probably the biggest song from Bat Outta Hell 1. I don't think I've ever done a show with Meatloaf where we haven't played it.
Car, sex, girl, and sports, you know. Like, I mean, how much more could a guy want?
It wasn't just a guy singing a song. It was a guy and a girl having angst and tension.
I get nervous every time before I do that number. But once I get started, I try to just have fun and relax, because I know if I get caught up in, you know, the legacy that was before me in Paradise, I won't be performing to the best of my ability. Stop right there. I started singing when I was a toddler. Grew up doing musical theater mostly. And then I got into the studio aspect of it, doing jingles, voicing cartoon characters, singing background vocals for albums. I haven't had a whole lot of experience touring, so I'm excited. every move in that entire thing is choreographed because we have it all timed out to that whole narration of the baseball sequence.
Phil Rizzuto, right? He does the play-by-play in the middle of the song.
Okay, here we go. We got a real pressure cooker going here. Two down, nobody on, no score, bottom of the ninth.
Everything else we pretty much make up as we go along, but the makeout section is choreographed. In Paradise, I think Meat definitely is able to go back to his high school years. He has this innocence and this kind of goofy, comedic, but really likable character. But the two of us have kind of found a groove together. So I try to just have fun. And Meat's so much fun to perform with, you know. Make me sick!
By my calculations, over the past 30 years, Meatloaf has performed Paradise by the Dashboard Light about 8,900 times. Most rock stars hate performing their old hits, but I'm not feeling that with Meat. For him, pleasing is a sacred duty, and he knows he will always please by performing Paradise just like he did in 1977. We demand it of him. So I guess it was inevitable that something had to give, and that the song would soon consume him and those around him in unexpected ways.
You get away with murder yesterday. You're not gonna get away with murder today. We're gonna be more of a fly on the wall today. Okay? No more spinning around me. Not that I don't love you, I do love you. But you took great advantage of your camera yesterday.
Love, but I won't do that, is that song was number one on the Billboard charts for 5 weeks in 1993. There's not too many songs that have done that over the years.
Some days it don't come easy, and some days it don't come hard, some days it don't come at all, and these are the days that never end.
It was the song that brought back Meatloaf to the popularity that he enjoyed in the late 70s, early 80s.
Oh, I would do anything for love. Oh, I would do anything for love. But I won't. Thank you.
critics does. I can't pay attention to critics. And I'll tell you why you can't pay any attention to critics. Is because I've had critics give me good reviews for shows, and I knew for a fact that the show sucked. And then I've known that we have done great shows, and the critics have given us bad reviews, and I can't, you can't pay any attention to them, you can't believe them.
So you're like a summer dream, and you're the answer to every prayer that I ever said. So you're like a summer dream, and you're the answer to every prayer that I ever said.
I guess, you know, to be in this business, anybody that does what I do, you have this need to kind of be the center of attention. I mean, it just comes with the territory. When I was younger, I don't know if I wanted it or not, because I was very quiet, very shy, didn't talk. In 3 years of being at Thomas Jefferson High School, if I spoke 12 words, I'd be actually shocked and surprised. I can't. It's too fast.
You just did. If it ain't broke, break it. You're screaming, and if it ain't broke. You're screaming and blind as a bat. You can't go from here to here quick.
Can't do it. It's a very, very hard gig. How he physically does it, I have no idea how he gets up for that.
Me will finish what? The one song in the encore?
Yes.
I think he's done. You try doing what he does for 2 hours. See if you want to continue.
Hi, I'm tired now. I did voiceover work for somebody today.
Jim Jones started his own church in the mid-50s in his home state of Indiana.
And then someone decided he was going to talk to me for like 2 or 3 hours.
You have road rage?
No, but I call people idiots and morons when they don't, especially people on cell phones. Then I sang, and then I started this show. I can't remember who that was, but if we see him, he's going to lose his shoes.
Any great artist, you know, why did Sinatra keep performing? Why don't artists retire? If they can do their work at a standard that makes them happy, they want to see the audience. The audience is their mirror, that they're still at that standard. And I believe that's what's at stake here for Meatloaf.
5 days of rehearsal is not long enough. It's not long enough because I can't put it together.
Last word for that.
Okay, what's the last word?
You tell me.
Stress.
Sleep.
Stress. Let's see. I left my house. And 22 and a half hours ago in LA to get here.
That's not right.
No, it's not right. But the poor band, they left Palm Springs yesterday at 2:00, and they're still not here. They're just getting on a plane in Vancouver right now. So that's welcome to touring.
He's realistic. He knows that these things can happen. The reason we came in on the 26th was so he could have a full rest day before the first main show of the tour. You know, obviously he would have slept last night. He could have slept late today. He would have had a whole day to relax and not worry about anything. Hello. Yeah. Okay, bye.
What happened?
Only two of them got luggage. The luggage is not arrived in Vancouver yet.
Oh.
What a nightmare.
Oh, you're kidding me.
No, no. It does take its toll on him a bit. He does stress about it a little bit. I mean, it's obvious, you know.
Oh, man.
They don't want us to come here.
Oh, man. That's... Wow.
Hopefully, we'll see the band in about an hour.
Center one. That's the wrong one. Center. On stage.
Travel nightmares usually last the most 12, 13, 14 hours. This one lasted a full 48 hours.
It definitely was the worst travel day I have ever had in my entire life. And that was including the 15 years I've been here with me. It's the worst.
It's had a hell of a trip getting here.
What happened?
It took us about 27 hours to go 50 miles.
It was just so unacceptable at this point in the tour, because the tour has just started, and already there are these, you know, these just like huge speed bumps that are just slowing us down.
We could have flown to Australia, had a drink, flown back, and beat it. It sucked.
This is brutal. I felt cold. I don't like cold. Yeah.
How's the venue look?
Like every other freaking venue we've ever played at.
Bob. It's all right. We have to rest his voice, and right now he just can't do it.
We just want to film his rituals.
He just can't. Maybe a little later, but his voice is hurting him already. He's getting ready for the show.
I believe Meat guards his privacy. I believe Meat wants his privacy.
Meatloaf spent so much time alone as a child, that sort of conditioned the way he is as an adult. He was used to being alone, he likes to be alone, he doesn't socialize really that much. His whole social life is thrown into his performance.
I hate rehearsals. When it gets right is out here. Tonight is the first night of right. This is when it starts to get right.
It's exciting when you're out there and you see the people.
Every night before we go on stage, we do this thing called the kill. It's where we all get in a big huddle and put our hands together, and Mark Alexander screams, "What do big dogs do?" And we say, "Kill."
What do we always do? Kill. What do big dogs do? Kill.
You gotta get in here.
Everybody's gotta be in here.
And I think it's just a little 20-second ritual to kind of bring everybody together for a show.
This is Victoria. Mark.
What are we gonna do?
Kill!
What do we always do?
Kill!
What do we need to do?
Kill!
What do big dogs do?
Kill!
We'll be right back.
awesome, and Meatloaf still rocks.
It's like he was 20 years ago.
Exactly. Yeah. Feels good.
We pulled some stuff tonight, which is totally out of left field that nobody knew was going to happen. And, well, extending certain parts and making other parts a little bit longer and shorter and different, and makes it impossible to have everybody really tight because you don't know what he's going to do next. So we're still rusty. We're still getting our sea legs.
Right now I'm so tired. I don't know what I'm doing, and I hated every minute of it. And I'm really bummed. I didn't like the show. It wasn't good for me. It's just got to be better in Vancouver, and that's all.
No matter what band you're in, what movie you're filming, what play you're doing, there's always going to be naysayers, people who have issues with what you're doing.
I later found out that this was not the first time otherwise admiring critics have come down on Meat and Aspen for their staging of Paradise, and it was obvious that this would not be the last of it. Far from it.
God, I don't know. It's a game called hockey that I know absolutely nothing about. I'm very tired right now. Really don't want to go to the hockey game. I must confess.
I'm not like Elton and those guys that I would love to be. It's just not my nature where they can just real schmoozers, you know, and they just turn up here and do that and go there, and they're everywhere, and They have the gift of gab, and I don't have that gift of, I mean, I can talk, but when I'm out at a premiere or something, I never know what to say to anybody.
Can I say hi?
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
What's your name?
Dwayne.
Dwayne, me. Nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
How are you? Hi, Bill.
Me. Nice to meet you.
How you doing?
I'm Dean.
Nice to see you.
I want to introduce you to Carol. She actually won the opportunity to be here today.
Oh, okay. Hi, Carol. How are you, dear?
No way! Yeah. What do you say? What did that?
Whoa, what's this?
Oh, hey, how are you? How you doing? Hi, Tom.
How are you?
How are you?
Good to see you.
What's your name?
I'm John.
Hi, John.
Nice to meet you. When I was a youngin, my sister was a big fan of Bread, the band. And for her birthday, I went to the store to buy her an album, and I got all confused, and I bought her Meatloaf instead of Bread. But she loved it. She loved it anyway. But I thought that was a pretty good story.
You know, he's getting a lot of press, actually. It's slowly starting to come around.
Any fond memories of Vancouver, coming here in previous tours?
Well, no, but I've done a lot of film and television work up here.
Like, yeah, he's got that novelty factor. It's Meatloaf. There's only one guy, and he's been around for so long, so press has got a story there, which is good. It's good to see them latch onto it.
Fight Club wasn't here, though, was it?
No, Fight Club wasn't here. Blacktop was here. I did an Outer Limits here. I did a Delta Force.
Thanks so much for doing this.
Oh, no problem. Thank you very much for having me. Oh.
Quiet, mate.
Yeah. Go and be quiet for a little bit.
It was a golden moment for music legend Meatloaf when Lainey presented him with official gold record status for Bat Out of Hell 3.
Meatloaf, you're making your way across Canada for the Bat Out of Hell 3 Seize the Night Tour.
This is my very first album.
Really? Your very first album?
Well, my first Meat album.
Who's this to?
do you have any rituals you do before you go on stage?
Oh, not so many, it's ridiculous.
Would you sign your name to one of your scarves?
I only have, you have this one. I have to take all my vitamins precisely 45 minutes before we go on stage. Did you get this from me?
No.
Because at one time we had a couple, but now I literally only have one red scarf. I have to get on my stretch machine. I have to warm up. I mean, it's endless. It takes me forever. And I start panicking when I run out of time. Well, guys, I'm going to go warm up. It was a pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you.
All right, have fun.
Enjoy the show.
Enjoy it. Thanks. I hope I have a good show for you.
Thanks.
Okay. It's a lot of work before the show. A lot of work before the show. I'm freaking out now. What time is it?
6:45.
Oh, fuck. Where are they?
Go TC.
Cleaning lady through
the window. What do you mean that the cleaning lady threw? How can a cleaning lady throw out?
Seemingly, he left them on his desk and she cleaned it out off the corner.
Where are they staying?
Where were you staying?
Where are you staying? I throw everything away? Hotel? Ask George, did it say Meatloaf on the CD? What did it say on the CD?
Did it have anything written on the CD? Did it have anything written on it, like Meatloaf or anything like that?
Because they're going to boot like this. They're going to boot like this.
Roll your head side to side, think nasal.
He's fine now, he'll be fine. He's in now doing his thing. It's good.
Everyone thinks you were like beyond on game.
No, not there yet. No, pissed off. Really mad.
Well, when he faints after a show, he's given so much. But at the same time, you're talking about somebody who is a method actor. You know, he has to put himself into a place where he's going to be exhausted if he's going to give everything.
How's my hair?
Hair's great.
It's great.
Okay, good. Hair's gonna always look good. I'm a sex god, you know.
Another night sleepless. I don't wanna feel this. Nothing can stop this pain. Trying to get to a time I forget you. Still tangled in yesterday. It's so easy for you to feel nothing for me.
Every tour has a turning point, and this one did too. The city was Calgary, where over the next few days, I would watch a couple of pesky ongoing issues come to dominate Meat's life.
Okay, here we go. We got a real pressure cooker going here. Two down, nobody on, no score, bottom of the ninth. There's the wind up, and there it is, a line shot up the middle. Look at him go. This boy can really fly. He's rounding first, he's really turning around now. He's not letting up at all. He's going to try for second. The ball is bobbled out of center, and here comes the throw, and what a throw. He's going to slide in head first. Here he comes. He's out. No wait, save, save that second base. This kid really makes things happen out here.
Double time tonight to get out the same performance as last night.
Thank you.
If I wasn't feeling well, I'd want to get a doctor in as well.
He seems to be okay, and that's about the only details I can give you because it's medical and it's confidential, but I'll certainly be available if he needs some help later on, either today, later on tonight, or tomorrow, that kind of thing.
What is your name?
Lindsay.
Hi, Lindsay. Paul.
Paul. Nice to meet you.
Okay, wait.
Hi. What?
Maybe we can talk all night.
Well, I'm sure we'll see you later on, right?
Right.
Yeah. Thanks.
Because you know, I started drinking.
I know exactly what's going to happen now. No more Mr. Subtle. Like I've ever been accused of being subtle. Now I'm going to hit him over the head with a glittered rake. All right, I got to finish packing. Okay, bye.
I've been awake since 8 o'clock, working on the show. Even like The Guardian in the UK, who gave us 4 out of 4 stars for the show, and another paper that gave us 5 out of 5 stars, they were always talking about the thing about me and Aspen. And the reason is because she's so small. She's small.
I think a huge reason is because I look like I'm 12 years old, making out with my grandpa, and every reviewer can't get past it. And even when we give a really, really good show, they devote half the review to talking about Paradise and how he's like a creepy old man. And they miss the whole point of the rest of the show. So I think he's just getting frustrated.
Guys, we're on stage. It's a friggin' fantasy. This isn't reality. I've always given people a lot of credit for being smart. I'm about to stop that. I'm about to stop giving people credit for having some intelligence, because it's like if the newspaper journalist, if they can't, it's like they give you a good review and then call you a child molester. You know, it's like, what's wrong with these people? I gotta keep packing.
It's very frustrating. I try really hard not to get caught up in the negative stuff that we hear about my age, or our age difference, or the outfits that we wear, or our hairstyles, things that just don't really matter. Because to the most of the people that come to see these concerts, that's not what it's about.
I mean, it's like, it happens all the time in the movies. Michael Douglas, you know, is out with, Gwyneth Paltrow. He's married to Gwyneth Paltrow. Gwyneth Paltrow, Michael Douglas is 60, Gwyneth Paltrow's 19 or something. And it's all the time.
I got a call early this morning from Meatloaf. He wasn't feeling very well, but he had some special instructions for me to alert the band that he's changing everything in Paradise. He's changing the whole look of Paradise, where it was a sports theme.
What I'm doing is I'm taking the entire beginning into so far out that nobody can possibly relate to it as reality. We are going so far into the 70s that you it's a big costume party.
He wants us to look like Casey and the Sunshine Band. So he sent everybody in the band out on a mission for 70s clothes. Afro wigs, velvet pants, suede vests, fringe, bell bottoms.
And I'm coming out looking exactly like I did in 1977. Long hair, frilly tuxedo shirt, red scarf, tuxedo jacket. I'm coming out 1977.
There it is.
Was there a bad review or something last night?
No. I don't think there was a bad review. I just think that he's out of his
only
mind.
Only the one about.
I read one that said, called Cease. They said, they shouldn't have had those two skinny skanks singing.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Shelter.
Yeah.
The two skinny skanks?
Two skinny skanks.
Where was that from?
From Vancouver.
They called you skinny skanks?
Yeah. Can you believe that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, this is the Herald.
Herald, yeah.
Oh, even us skeptics found ourselves humming along. Sniff, how could you not?
I believe Meatloaf cares about critics, and he shouldn't.
When I see 12,000 people, and I see them and they loved it, and they don't care that it's, at times, campy.
My favorite line in any review was kind of a mixed review, but what was it? The most surreal night. The entire night was the most surreal night I've ever had. I thought that was absolutely dead on. You can't get any better quote than that one. That, you know, instead of bombastic or really good or excellent or all this, surreal is exactly what I'm going for. I'm just screaming and the fires
are howling way down. He's relaxing in bed at the hotel right now. We're up freezing our behinds off.
I can't wait. There's evil in the hand,
there's thunder in the sky, and a killer's on the bloodshot street. Look at that.
I don't want to look like a clown. With a deadly horizon, no, I
swear I saw a young boy. Guys would wear this though in the 70s. Definitely.
Oh, right there.
Yes! Hey, everybody, come see how good I look.
Marsha.
YMCA.
Somebody probably died in his shirt.
Let me check your in scene.
I wouldn't be picking that to wear.
Nah, it's not speaking to me.
It's great stuff, but it's just not over the top enough for me.
No one seems to be able to find anything that's stage worthy. So at least we've made a valiant effort, but it doesn't look good.
People think it's 1,000% glamour all the time.
Well, it is, can't you tell? How glamorous is this at the moment? How glamorous is this, my baggie with my wheat thins in it? This is pure glamour.
I've always been a fan of Meat, and the Meatloaf that I know is a really down-to-earth, regular person who has no connection to a stage persona, as one might think. That's what I think of Meat. Great family man. Very loyal to his friends. A little bit neurotic.
Hey.
Hi, Dennis.
Hi, buddy.
How you doing, baby?
How's it going?
Good, good.
So I'll tell you what's going on.
This is
I'm
here.
Feeling fine right now.
Yeah.
Every time I go to sing, I start spinning.
Okay. He's an angster. He likes to angst about things. He enjoys angsting.
Something's going on inside my ears. I'm having vertigo. Sinus dripped. Start sweating. I'm just spinning.
I'm not talking.
This is killing me.
Nice to meet you, Paul. How are you?
Big fan.
Thank you. Yeah. How are you? All right, man. How's it going?
Great. I've never seen Meat live.
No, I've not.
I'm old and it sucks now, Dennis.
Yeah, I'm sure. We're all old.
We're doing 100 shows this year.
Holy crap.
Wow.
I think we're on 8. So, Dennis, if you have the urge, it's we rehearsed. I'm not going to be one of those guys that goes, well, Dennis Quaid's out there. And you know what? And I think he should come up here and sing a song with us. Yeah.
Might as well, he does in every bar.
Give it up. Give it up, people. Not something we can rehearse, we just have to do it. There's no
okay.
To the music, so it's gonna
we just have to do it.
So this isn't gonna be creepier this way? That we're making out for like 3 minutes?
We don't have to like, you know, lip lock. You can do like, you know,
yeah, we just start and you know, just do this and like
right, okay.
But
they're gonna still find this creepy.
Well, people can watch the video. That's the idea.
We're hoping they're watching the video.
Maybe we should just stop and turn around and watch the video.
Okay. Look, this will work. This will work. That's a good idea. What we do is we'll start center, and then we'll go like this.
And the normal.
No, we won't.
Oh, but I act like I want to.
Yeah, then all of a sudden the video comes on.
Oh.
And then we'll just take a couple of steps like this and angle ourselves like that.
Yep.
And we'll watch it, and then I'll put my arm around you, and we're watching the thing.
Nice. I think it'll be less creepy than us making out the whole time.
Yeah, I agree. I wasn't ready. Because Billy said, I want you to do what they were doing, and then I'm watching it going, I don't know if that's going to work.
I don't think that fixes the problem.
That doesn't fix the problem, no.
Okay.
Okay, we're going up on stage, Bill.
You want my take on the Aspen debacle? You know, I think that people don't understand that it's stage. You know, it's a play. It's really Beauty and the Beast.
What? Do this one again.
Off stage, he's got the most respect in the world for women. He's got young daughters.
Now.
You know, people have to get over this age thing. I think it's critics speak.
Perfect. Okay.
I think at this point that Meatloaf, unfortunately, is frustrated.
We'll do it at rehearsal. When I get the band up for sound check.
I caught a night.
Oh, okay.
She makes me feel all right.
We're building.
And her name is G.
Right, and that's all E-D, yeah. E-D, yeah. And then once you get to the end of that, we go, bah, 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 bah. Okay, all right.
So we have the leather vest, the dashiki, the two pimp outfits, the headband on John, and the long pimp coat on Dave. And then do you see what the girls are wearing?
No.
So the chorus is just E to D? Is that a cast?
Well, no, that's the body of the song, is that? That's all verse.
E, D, A, really, is the way I play it.
That's the chorus.
Okay.
And the verse. But it doesn't go back to that until the very end of the song.
Say about my baby!
All right.
She come around.
That, you know, Liv is that middle part, well.
Walking down my street.
That's just D.
Okay.
She's coming to my house.
Oh, okay, that's real. Oh, good. Okay, now that's good.
Randy.
Yes.
We're doing Gloria.
Gloria.
Okay.
E.
Voices in your head. Calling Gloria.
Ah, Gloria. With Dennis Quaid. He's gonna play your Gibson. He's gonna knock the shit out of it.
That's only Gloria we know. Apparently, we're one of the other Gloria.
Winnipeg.
What are we gonna do?
Kill!
What do we always do?
Kill!
What do we need to do?
Kill!
Winnipeg!
There's the windup, and there it is, a line shot of the middle. Look at him go. This boy can really fly. It's in the dirt, safe at third. Holy cow, stolen base. Taking a pretty big lead.
It is only one night and one night only. I would cherish the next moment. I mean, I would cherish the next moment. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dennis Quaid.
Meatloaf has brought the springtime back to Winnipeg.
That was really an honor. Thanks, Dennis.
Well, it was really an honor with you, buddy.
Oh.
I spent time with you. You got to direct me for once.
Oh, yeah, right. Yeah, that's me.
That was an incredible show.
Thank you, Dennis.
Yeah.
It wasn't one of my favorite, but thank you.
Al, how many times are they your favorite?
Never. Yeah. I hate them all.
I know. That's what I told them, that you're an angster.
I can't.
Angster.
Oh, I'm waiting for the perfect show.
Do you spare
all I need is this box of Wheat Thins, and I'm okay.
It's ready, guys.
And with most wigs, you get a really nasty front line. This breaks it up.
Okay. And it's not too thick.
No, you don't want it too thick. And we can part that anywhere you like. Right now it's
And we can thin it out even.
Oh yeah. That's easy. But you're gonna want some nice hair.
Right. Now, is this nice?
This is nice.
Okay.
This is what we call virgin European.
Okay, I don't know.
Okay, we're gonna make him look like he's on the dashboard light, okay?
Okay.
All right. This is not gonna look anything like a finished product, but.
Right, got it.
Here we are. What about the length?
It needs to be longer, it's too short.
It needs to be longer?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
That's thin. Okay, good. Now I just gotta figure out how I did that. I did it like that. There you go.
Okay, let me saw that clip then.
There you go. That's it.
Nice, you're back.
Yeah, sorta.
It looks good.
How do you feel?
It's really funny. See, if I just now, we just played with it and just did it, it looks like my hair. It looks exactly right.
That's good news. Good news.
It looks exactly right.
This isn't a normal show day.
Today we're setting up for a new DVD.
So it's a really intensive day.
We just need to make sure it's perfect. It's obviously going to DVD forever and ever, so it's gotta be on the money.
How you feeling?
Good.
You
good, right?
Yeah.
We're gonna really do good today,
yes,
right?
Yes, we are.
Yeah.
Yes,
it's
we
gonna
are.
Be really good.
It's gonna be
we're
great.
Gonna have fun.
Yes,
right?
We're gonna have fun.
We're gonna have a good show. It's gonna be the best show that we've ever done.
It's gonna be the best show.
I'm not
we've
doing
ever
it
done.
For him either.
I know, I know.
I'm serious about that. I knocked on your door to tell you that.
Oh, I wasn't there, I was probably
I know.
In the gym.
You were. But I'm just telling you that, okay?
Yep.
All right.
Okay.
You know I'm there for you, right?
Yeah.
You know I love you.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you love me?
Mm-hmm.
You sure?
Okay. So now take a deep breath and hiss. Keep your mouth relaxed and your jaw relaxed. And throw that gum out, mister. No. Oh my God.
Me, 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 me.
Mom, oh, mom, oh, mom, oh, mom, oh.
Now gesture freely with your arms.
Me, 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 me.
I think it's sounding good. I'm really happy. It sounded very clear. What'd you just do?
Oh, I don't know. Oh, I don't know.
I thought you just got shocked.
No.
Is your back?
Yeah. Oh.
That's probably because you're tense.
Back spasms. Oh.
Maybe you need to take something.
What?
Maybe you need to take something. Slow and breathe. Is it more stressful for you with the DVD?
Yeah, you're here and the DVD. Like fucking Stress City, except for I'm happy. I'm positive. The show's gonna be great. We're bringing in positive energy. We don't want any negativity. Everything's gonna be just great.
Silly. This is unbelievable.
So I look like the guy who played me in the movie. Nobody else has the nerve for this shit. London! Ontario. What are we gonna do?
Kill!
What do we always do?
Kill!
What do we need to do?
Kill!
What do we need to do?
Kill!
Oh, you old man!
Come true. I am a varsity champ.
really flying. He's rounding first and really turning it on now. He's not letting up at all. He's going to try for second. The ball is bobbled out in center, and here comes the throw, and what a throw. He's going to slide in head first. Here he comes. He's out. No, wait, safe. Safe at second base. This kid really makes things happen out there. Batter steps up to the plate. Here's the pitch, and he's going, and what a jump he's got. He's trying for third. Here's the throw. It's in the dirt. Safe at third. Holy cow, stolen base. Taking a pretty big lead out there, almost daring him to try and pick him off. Pitcher glances over, winds up, and it's bunted, bunted down the third baseline. The suicide squeezes on. Here he comes, squeeze play, it's going to be close. Here's the throw, here's the play of the plate. Holy cow, I think he's going to make it.
Stop right there. I got to know right now.
I'm thrilled with how it went tonight. Honestly, I think we had a big breakthrough. Well, I've gotten several comments already saying that I looked a little older. Which is good. And I was less naked, which is good, so I'm happy. I think the audience actually gave us one of the best responses we've gotten so far. I hope it took the edge off the creepiness. I hope so. Maybe the wig combined with the cheerleading combined with the pimp necklaces, I don't know, maybe magically made it not creepy.
Let me sleep on it, I give you an answer in the morning. Let me sleep on it. Baby, baby, let me sleep on it.
Okay, go ahead.
To follow our storyline, Paradise, this was the premiere, okay, of Paradise. Were you happy? Did it hit your vision of what you wanted it to be?
Did it hit my paradise, hit my vision? I don't know if it hit my vision, but it hit a vision. Trust me, it was a vision.
Meat thrives on taking big risks creatively. I think he kind of gets off on that.
Fuck you.
I think Meatloaf has endured because he expresses the energy, the joy and exuberance, the kind of overflowingness of life. He's an eternal character in, you know, like Falstaff or Cyrano, and that's why he survived. We want this person, and there he is.
Meatloaf is about winning, and until he wins, he doesn't stop. And at the very, very end, when he looks all around the arena and he walks or runs back and forth on that stage, he's surveying whether or not he won.
Over and over, I was told by those who know him, don't worry, he's been doing this for years. For Meat, they say, it's just another day at the office.
I tried. I'm great.